Why has it taken this country so long to deal with the infrastructure? What's the problem?
Well, the problem, Charlie, is that the Republicans don't want to pay for anything. You know, when I was in the Senate, I was on the committee that was responsible for writing the bill, the highway transportation bill. It was hard because we had a lot of back and forth, but we came out with a bill. We got it done. There has not been a bill that has actually come out for years now. And so the Congress is in the middle of arguing about whether or not they can get a highway bill. But they don't want anybody to pay anything for it. And so they don't want to use user fees. They don't want any kind of fee that could be construed as a tax. Okay. Now, at some point...
That's how they view fees.
At some point, you know, we are crumbling. I mean, every independent assessment says the same thing. We have a failing grade, or maybe at the most a D
minus.
And
putting our citizens at risk.
Well, and costing them money. You know, in a lot of places in this country, people pay a lot to fix axles and wheels and other things that are damaged by potted and deteriorating roads. We have a lot of bridges that, you know, if you had a choice, you wouldn't cross because they are not in very good shape. Our airports, we don't have a single airport in the top 20 airports in the entire world. The closest we get is Cincinnati at 30. I mean, we have watched over the deterioration, to say nothing of what you can't see. Because under the ground, you know, in New York, we got water mains and sewer mains and gas lines. Some of them are blowing up and some of them are cracking.
So did we miss an opportunity during the first 4 years of the Obama administration to do more?
Well, we did as much as the Congress would let the administration do. The Recovery Act had Build America bonds. They had money going into all kinds of construction. We could have done a lot more, and we'd be better off if we had.